My name is Rohit, and we'll be talking about edge computing and how this edge computing is being used with OpenStack Cloud to host multiple applications. So over here, I've just given an example of IoT, but you can host multiple applications like IoT applications, 5G enabled applications, AR VR application, any kind of applications. Yeah. So I'll be collaborating with Nilesh. These are short, very, very short bio. That is, we are OpenStack engineers. So this is what we have in our plate today. Those who are not aware about what is exactly edge computing and those are aware about cloud computing. So for them, just a quick intro to edge computing. Then distributed computing network with OpenStack, then spine leaf topology, it's a network topology. Then a director-based deployment method, how we'll be deploying the exact the OpenStack. Then how to scale your edge deployment, that is basically your OpenStack cloud. Then potential failures, limitations, and at the end we have very interesting demo for edge computing. So say stay tuned. Yeah. So you guys have heard about exactly what is about cloud computing, right? So what is a cloud? Cloud is nothing but a huge configuration server sitting at some remote place, and you guys are accessing that server using some kind of application, maybe a browser, and then paying as per your usage, then scaling that cloud. That is nothing but a cloud computing. But what exactly is edge computing? Any guesses? Okay. Yeah. So edge is nothing but whenever we have some kind of production servers deployed, and it's kind of difficult to manage production servers at different remote locations from a centralized location. At that time, this kind of concept is useful. So this edge computing is nothing but a distributed computing environment where we are managing this environment using OpenStack Cloud, okay? And then we can use this environment for hosting, as I said, different kind of applications like IoT, VR, AR kind of applications. Okay, so DCN with OpenStack. DCN nothing but distributed computing network. So if you see over here, this is a block diagram which shows the block diagram of OpenStack. So over here, the upper part is, if you can see, the first is under cloud, then we have container registry, controller nodes, compute nodes, and volume. So this is nothing, the first block is nothing but your OpenStack environment. Okay, so forget about this part, this is our exactly edge nodes, that is edge computing. So first I'll just focus on the upper part. So if you guys are aware about how exactly OpenStack architecture is, OpenStack has its under cloud node, over cloud node, then the storage node, and on the over cloud node you host your VMs, and then on that VMs you host your application. So if you see, we have an under cloud, then we have container registry for storing the images, then we have controller nodes, compute nodes, and volume. So the compute nodes will be using the local ephemeral storage or any kind of storage which you are having, you can use that storage. And then comes our edge side, that is the DCN side. So in between we have L3 routing. So L3 routing is nothing but your MPLS network where you have your L3 layers of devices, switches, routers, and that switches router are connecting to our compute nodes which resides at remote locations. So if you see in this diagram, I have my OpenStack environment upside, and this OpenStack environment is connected to my edge nodes. Compute 1, Compute 2, and Compute 3. So these are my edge nodes. Okay, so talking about the topology. So there are multiple different topology in network. There's star, hub, ring, mesh. So what kind of topology is useful in this scenario for hosting our edge computing? So if you see, I have a spine switches at the top. We have three spine switches. So I was talking about L3 routing, right, in the previous slide. So L3 routing stands over there. So these are spine switches. Under the spine switches, so consider these three columns as a single server rack. Okay, so this is the one rack, another rack, and third one rack. So in each rack, I have multiple nodes. Under cloud, controller, controller one, controller two, leaf, and rest of the nodes. So each rack has similar kind of nodes. So this is how exactly spine leaf topology works. I have the main spine switch. Main spine switch is connected to the switch which is located in the rack, and the switch connects to all this compute, controller, and under cloud nodes. So if you are aware about how exactly OpenStack deployment works, so there are multiple deployment methods for installing or setting up this OpenStack. So we are considering over here the director-based deployment method. Okay. So director-based deployment method is nothing but we are using some sort of YAML files. So YAML files are nothing but it's a kind of what things you need to deploy or what kind of network you want to have, what kind of services you need to have in your OpenStack environment. So these are nothing but the YAML files. So using this YAML file, we are making this director-based deployment. So initially in the first slides, I said OpenStack has two parts, that is the under cloud and over cloud. So considering this edge scenario, what are the things we need to make change in our under cloud node? Okay. So this is a snippet of a JSON file. So as I said, there are multiple nodes in OpenStack environment. I need to define parameters for those nodes that those nodes should be visible to my OpenStack cloud. So this is the JSON file where I need to mention those parameters. So I mentioned just the info about one of the nodes. So I'll mention MAC address, the name of that node, number of CPU, memory, disk, then physical machine type, username, password, address. The third important thing is deploy interface direct. So this is the only change which I need to make in my under cloud in order to make this environment work. That's the first thing. And the second thing is Swift URL. So Swift is nothing but an object storage in OpenStack. So this object storage is used to store some kind of images, some sort of data, and it works on the under cloud. So if I want to just transfer the data from my edge nodes to the original central site, so this will be used. This will be done by using Swift URL configuration. Yeah. So that was about under cloud. Then what about over cloud nodes? Okay. So over cloud, we can have multiple edge nodes. So this is just an example or snippet of one of the edge nodes. Okay. So there is a default role file for each of the nodes. So if you see the location, there is user share OpenStack triple O heat templates role and compute.yaml file. So this, what this exactly YAML file do? So this YAML file has all kind of definition regarding the edge nodes. Okay, all kind of information, what things I need to have for that edge node. So all this information is present in this file. Okay, so likewise, you can have multiple such files and just put it as a parameter while deploying your OpenStack cloud. Okay, so I'll just read out what are the things over here. So this is the role compute AZ1. So AZ is nothing but kind of a zone one. Then the name of the compute node, and the description, if you want, you can put some basic compute node role. Then the count, so right now I have only single node, so this count is one. And the kind of networks which will be using, internal API network. So internal API network will be used for communicating your compute nodes with the controller nodes, then tenant network, then the storage network. Then you'll be having your host name, then role parameter defaults, then TUND profile, virtual hosts, and display upgrade deployment. So these are the kind of optional parameters. Yeah. So as I said, this specific edge computing is being used by telecommunication companies for hosting their applications. So if you take an example of any telecommunication companies, they're not working in a single country. They're working in multiple, all over the region, all over the globe. So how they exactly communicate with the central one? Okay. So if you see over here, I'll be deploying my cloud at this central site. This is OpenStack cloud. In my OpenStack cloud, there's a director node, controller node, and we can have controller, compute as well as storage node. So this is my central site where my OpenStack environment is hosted. And these three are my edge nodes. So and my edge nodes, I'll be having CentOS, any kind of application, any kind of operating system, Red Hat operating system, Ubuntu operating system. And these two are connected via my MPLS network, that is the backhaul network, where my physical router, switches, all those kind of devices will be present. Okay? And this is a part of application where we can host any kind of application on your edge nodes. Yeah. Coming to the scaling, let's say my business grows and I need some more resources, some more servers to put at my edge site. So how exactly the scaling of this edge computing works? Okay? So here we are scaling the compute nodes one by one or in group or in batches. Okay. The scalability of compute node is limited by what the undercloud can manage. It all dependent on resources. Exactly. So this depends upon how much load your undercloud can manage so that it can just control all your edge devices. So your undercloud should be capable of managing all your edge devices. So as per my knowledge, till now 150 physical edge devices has been tested successfully in the environment, production environment. And yeah, so whenever you'll be doing scaling, it's a kind of, you know, iterative job. So it's better to just scale in batches or one by one, so that in case some failure happen, it should not disturb your entire environment. So this is how exactly scaling works with the compute nodes. Yeah. So planning about the potential failures. Let's say I'm deploying this edge computing environment. So how should I plan for to deal with the failures in my environment? Okay. So regarding the controller nodes failure. So this is a kind of HA, high availability management. So I'll be having some three controller nodes. So in case any one of the controller nodes gets failed, the other two can manage the load. And there's no need to worry if the controller nodes gets failed. And compute nodes, yeah, there is need to worry because my application will be hosted on the compute nodes. If any one of the compute nodes gets down, I need to worry. And the storage nodes. So storage nodes has, you can consider any, the local storage or some external storage as well. So these are kind of, you know, important things which we need to consider while handling the potential failures. Then limitations. This edge computing being a kind of new technology or being used with this OpenStack Cloud for the first time, there are some sort of limitations or drawback, we can say. So the very first thing is can deploy only compute nodes as the edge side. So if you remember the very second slide, I have mentioned three edge nodes, three compute nodes. So I cannot have controller node or director node or storage node at my edge side. I can only have compute nodes at my edge side. And then network latency. Whenever you are hosting your application on the compute nodes, the network latency should not be more than 100 milliseconds. And network dropouts, then site-specific network, yeah. So for the edge nodes, the network should be same. It should not be different. Yeah, so we'll just see the demo.
Yeah, thanks Rohit. Good afternoon, guys. Thanks, Rohit. My friend Rohit just talked about the theoretical part. I will focus on the practical part, how we can deploy it, and at the end, how you can deploy your IoT application or any edge application onto the environment. So this is a demo regards to the OpenStack edge computing using the DCN technology, that is distributed computing networks or nodes. When I said distributing compute nodes, it means that my compute nodes are located onto the remote side, and onto the remote side, there is no controller or no undercloud nodes. You can see that in the central side, I have undercloud, controller, and computes. However, onto the remote side, there is only one compute node. So my cost is saving. I don't have to set up another OpenStack environment onto the edge side. Only the processing of the application, which will carry it by the open compute node. And this spine will manage the L3 routing between the two different networks. So that is actually the basic and the minimum configuration for the OpenStack edge setup using the distributed computing networks. So the next part is the setting up the overcloud nodes, how I can deploy it. So once my undercloud is ready, onto my undercloud, I have to mention two important things, that is the subnets. So as I'm using only two subnets, central side and the remote side, so I have just mentioned leaf 0 and leaf 1. If I have multiple subnets or multiple remote sites, then I have to add all that subnets over there. For the leaf 0, I'm using 24.0 cider. However, onto the leaf 1 side, I'm using 34.0 cider. So two different network, so definitely I need to have a L3 routing between two different networks. That's why we are using the spine for L3 routing between the two different network. Plus the important point is that whenever we are trying to set up a DCN or edge computing, we should have a DHCP relay between these two networks, so that whenever the remote compute nodes want to want to set up a networking between the central and the remote side. The central side should pass the network details to the remote side. So by default, the nodes works onto the control plane network. So you can see that here the physical network of each device is set by default set to the control plane network. So as my remote server having the different subnet, so I need to change that different subnet. The physical network is changed to the leaf one. The reason is because of the different CIDR subnet, what 24.0 CIDR network and the 34.0. So once my undercloud is set up, it's part to deploy to the overcloud nodes, and that is my template files which I am using to deploy the overcloud nodes. Important is network file, role files, and so on. Let's deploy it. So this particular topology I'm setting on QEMU emulator. It is not a KVM liveWorld layer. So I'm not able to manage the power cycle automatically. So for that matter, I have written a small Python script. This is Python script. This script will automatically manage the power of my compute nodes or my nodes which are get involved into the deployment. That will automatically turn off the machine, automatically pushes the configuration. So that while running that script, it will also ask me to pass the absolute path of the template file where I'm storing my templates. So once I ran the script, it asked me to pass the absolute path of my deploy script. The script is running, it's trying to import the node. You can see that in the bottom, this side, the nodes are imported. It's starting the VMs. You can see that the VMs are not yet started, but it will start. Still, the nodes are introspecting. Now you can see that the power status has been changed from off to on, and then you can see that the machines are on. The machine's color has been changed. That is the console. The introspection is going on. What is basically doing is, so whatever we have mentioned in the templates, it's collecting that data, it's storing into the undercloud, and once it is ready, it will push that configuration onto the central nodes as well as onto the remote nodes. Whatever the nodes are involved into the deployment, all gets automatically deployed by the script. Still, it is introspecting, and now you can see that the power status has been changed to the off. It means that the operating system gets installed onto the nodes, and after some time, it gets automatically off. It's still introspecting. Yeah, introspection is completed and the console has been gone. Yes. The introspection is completed and now it is waiting for the next call. So there are different calls involved during the deployment. So once the node's provision states is available, the next call is waiting on call. And once the script find it out that the provisioning state has been changed, it will again automatically starts the node and pushes the next, it will push the next configuration. Now you can see in the bottom, the stack creation is in the progress state. So whenever we create the, we run the OpenStack deployment, in the backend, it will create the stack. It will combine all the configuration and push that configuration on all the nodes. Into the sidebar, you can see that the progress, what it actually doing. So before the step one, it will collect all the information about the networks. The first part is to collect the network's detail. Once it has all the network details, it will push that network details onto the overcloud nodes. Controller, computes, and the storage nodes. At this moment, my nodes are still in the off state. It's not power on state because it is waiting for the callback. Now it will start once it gets the wait on callback signal. You can see that the power state and the provisioning state is on and wait call. It will move to the active state once the deployment is, once it pushes all the deployments to the overcloud nodes. Now it's deploying the rest of the configuration, what it collected before the step one. Now after the deploying, the nodes will again turn off. It's going off. And the provisioning state changed to the active state. Now, at this moment, the OpenStack deployment just collected the information what we passed into the template files, but it's not been completed. So there are total 5 steps to complete the configuration. So at the very first step, it will collect all the network detail, software detail, deployment detail, what networks I have to deploy onto my overcloud nodes. For example, onto the control node, I want only selected in networks. However, onto my compute nodes, I want 2-3 networks. Let's say onto the controller side, I want external connectivity, but onto the compute side, I don't want external connectivity. So I will create my templates according to that. Now you can say that, see that we are onto the step 3. As I said, there are total 5 steps. Into the step 3, what it will do, it will basically do the pacemaker configuration. So the pacemaker is another feature inside the OpenStack that will automatically manage your resources. Oh. We are onto the step 3, okay. Yes, we are now onto the step 5. Step 5, it's basically, at the step 5, it's basically verify your deployment, whether the previous steps successfully executed or not. And at last, we can see that the overcloud is deployed in 82 minutes. So once the OpenStack is deployed, what we will use to do is we use to create the VMs so that the end customer or the user can deploy their application. So the next part is I am deploying 3 VMs. The one VM is on edge side. When I say edge side, it means that my remote side. And I will deploy 2 VMs onto the central side, and we'll see how we can access that application. So you can see that here, I have compute leaf 1, that is my remote compute node, where the name of the VM is rd underscore edge and the status is active. That VM is running onto my remote location compute node. And I have another VM, that is rd central, which is on compute leaf 0, that is on my central side. And the name of the VM is rd underscore central and the status is active. That means I have, right now I have 2 VMs on central and remote side with the name of rd edge on edge side and rd central on central side. And the another VM is web server for simplification of easily go around to the different sites to access my or we can say that to easily navigate to the different application. So 3 VMs are currently running. And as I say that, I have another web server for easily navigation to the each application so that I don't have to go to the each site and check, and then I have to access the URL for the application. So I have contributed all the URLs in one single page so that I can easily navigate. At the very first page, I can go to my dashboard and I can check my VM details, my hypervisor details, I can access anything from the dashboard. So there are two ways to access the OpenStack environment. One is basically three ways. You can access via Horizon dashboard, CLI, and using API as well. So these two VMs are currently running, that is RD underscore edge and RD underscore central, and the web server, which is hosted onto the central side and as well as onto my remote side. Okay, so we talked more about just the deployment, and we were talking about the IoT, how we can deploy the application. So just my friend says that it's just not about the IoT. It can be a telco application as well. It can be a broadband application as well. It can be a non-telco applications as well, medical applications, educational applications. It can be any application. So here, as an IoT application, we are using a radius desk. That what this application will do is it will allow the users to easily access the internet from the mobile devices. So we have deployed two applications. One is on central side and one is on remote side. So you can see here the port detail is 10155. 155 is the IP of my central server. And once the next slide is coming, a video is coming, it will be replaced with the 158. 158 is my remote server, remote compute node, where the application is running. So here, I tested my username, whether it is authenticating or not. Yes, it is authenticated, so that I can access that application, or from the users from that region can access the application. You can see that the port is changed. Sorry, not this one. This one. The port is being changed to 158. Earlier it is 155. 155 is central and 158 is remote. And the username is, of course, the username is different for the remote sites, because that application will be locally to the remote users. We can test the application from the CLI as well. The central side is 155, and the remote is 158. I'm sending an API request to check whether that application is really working or not. So I'm sending just API command. Yes, I'm getting the accept acknowledgement. That means the application is well working onto the central side. Let's see onto the remote side. And yes, we are getting the success message. That means that the application is also working onto the remote side. So yes, that's all about the deploying your IoT application onto the OpenStack edge side and onto the remote side. Thank you, guys. Do you have any questions? Please feel free to ask. The question is, what happens if my L3 connectivity is lost to my edge node? So, the answer is like, of course, if you are deploying your OpenStack environment onto the edge side, at least there should be some failure link so that the traffic can be easily moved from one link to the another link. For example, if in a data center, we usually see that there are two links or multiple links into the data center, so that the redundancy should be there. If one goes down, the other link can be takeover, but it does not hamper the application which are hosted actually onto the compute node. So of course, there should be a routing between the two different networks, which is easily easily configured. Yes.
So in your opinion, whether the C OpenShift deployments are required?
Thank you.
Sorry?
So my question is, in your opinion, based on what you showed here, would it be C OpenShift, OpenStack deployments on the far edge? Mm-hmm. You see it?
Yes. So the question is, do we see any edge deployment?
So if I understood correctly, this presentation is about deploying OpenStack at the far edge of IoT.
Yes.
And really what I'm trying to lead is, how does this compete with Kubernetes on bare metal on the far edge?
Well, not sure about the Kubernetes OpenShift, but yes, for the telco applications, this definitely is going to help. And yes, the customers are still deploying their application onto the edge side.
So right now, the thing is that this application has been tested only for some kind of
telco customers.
Some VRAN devices, like which telco customer uses. So for Kubernetes and all those kind of things, the testing is still in kind of progress state, and we are still developing and testing those kinds.
So the reason is basically, if we are talking about Kubernetes and the OpenShift, the RAN application is not yet to be containerized. Once it is containerized, yes, there may be a chance we can deploy that CNF, the container application, onto the edge side. But right now, we don't see any containerized application, so no idea on it. But yes, from the OpenStack side, we have the VNF, that is the virtual network functions, that can be easily deployed onto the edge side.
Can use DVR, but if you have a
yes. So the question is, can we use the DVR? Yes, definitely we can use the DVR. That is, DVR is distributed virtual routing. But here is we are actually provide, and it's also depend on the use case. So if I have a telco application, I will not use the DVR because I'm directly providing the provider networks to my compute node, so that the there will be a direct access of the application. In case of DVR, maybe telco customers will not use that. But yes, you can definitely use that. It's up to the use case. Yeah, thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you.